Hello, good morning everyone. Today we will discuss about development history of IC and its fabrication parameters. Outline of the presentation, introduction, development history of IC, types of IC, on the basis of chip size, on the basis of applications, generation of IC or integration levels, structure of IC as well as fabrication parameters of IC, advantages and disadvantages of IC, conclusion. What is integrated circuits? A complex set of electronic components and their interconnections that are imprinted onto a tiny slice of semiconducting materials. In other words, we can say millions of active and passive components are fabricated on a single crystals of semiconducting materials known as integrated circuits. Usually we represent it in short IC or chips. Integrated circuits are usually called IC and popularly known as a silicon chip, computer chip or microchip. Development history of IC. We discuss about brief history of the development in IC. In 1940s, initial stage means looking up towards the integrated circuits in 1940. In 1945, Bell Lab established a group to develop a semiconductor replacement for vacuum tube. In 1947, transistor invented. Means transistor replaced vacuum tubes. In 1951, junction transistors invented. In 1958, integrated circuit was invented. In 1958, Texas Instruments developed first IC. In 1958, invention of the integrated circuit. As with many inventions, two people had the idea for an integrated circuit. Almost the same time, transistors had become commonplace in everything from radios to phones, phones to computers, and now manufacturers wanted something even better. Sure, transistors were smaller than vacuum tube, but all of the newest electronics, they were not small enough. In other words, we can say transistors are very smaller than vacuum tubes. You have seen vacuum tubes in olden radios, TV sets. They were replaced by transistors. In 1958, the invention of integrated circuits was continued. There was a limit on how small you could make each transistor. Since after it was made, it had to be connected to wires and other electronics components. The transistors were already at the limit of what steady hands and tiny tweezers could handle. So scientists wanted to make a whole circuit. The transistors, wires, everything as they needed in a single go. If they could not create without miniature circuits in just one step. In other words, we can say we create miniaturization circuits or all parts could be made much smaller. In 1958, invention of integrated circuits was continued by Texas Instruments. One day in late July, Jack Kilby was sitting along a Texas Instrument. He had been hired only a couple of months earlier and he was not able to take vacation time when particularly everyone else did. The halls were deserted and he had lot of time to think. It suddenly occurred to him that all parts of the circuit, not just the transistor alone, could be made out of silicon. At the same time, nobody was making capacitor or resistor out of the semiconductor. In 1958, invention of integrated circuit was completed by Texas Instruments. In the January 1959, Robert Noyce was working at a small Fairchild Semiconductor startup company. He also realized a whole circuit could be made on a single chip. While Kilby had hammered out of the details of making individual components, Noyce thought was a better way to connect the parts. The aspiring Fairchild began a push to build that they called Unity Circuit, and they also applied for a patent on the idea. Several hundred identical integrated circuits are made at a time on a thin wafer, several centimeters wide, and the wafer is subsequently sliced into individual IC called chip. In other words, we can say several slices are cutting from wafer for individual IC. Tiny electronic circuits used to perform a specific electronic function such as amplification. It is usually combined with other components to form a more complex system. Electronic component, miniaturized active devices, transistors, diodes, miniaturized passive devices, capacitor, resistor. It is formed as single unit by diffusing impurity into a single crystal of silicon, which then serves as a semiconductor material. Types of IC. Basically, we have classified IC on the basis of manufacturing, on the basis of chip size, and on the basis of application. On the basis of fabrication technique, one IC is monolithic IC, second thick and thin film IC, third hybrid IC. Monolithic IC. Mono means single, lithic means stone. Monolithic circuit is built into a single crystal or stone. That is, in monolithic IC, all circuit components and their interconnections are formed into or on the top of a single chip of silicon. Monolithic ICs are by far the most common type of IC used in practice because of mass production, lower cost, and higher reliability. Hybrid IC, the circuit is fabricated by interconnecting a number of individual chips. Hybrid ICs are widely used for high power audio amplifier applications, have better performance than monolithic IC. Process is too expensive for mass production. Hybrid circuits are often encapsulated in epoxy as shown in the image. A hybrid circuit serves as a component on PCB, printed circuit board, in the same way as a monolithic integrated circuit. The difference between the two types of devices in how they are constructed and manufactured. Thin and thick film IC. The devices are larger than monolithic IC, but smaller than discrete circuit. Discrete circuit means some circuits designed on the breadboard. These ICs can be used when power requirement is comparatively higher. With a thin or thick film IC, the passive components like resistors and capacitors are integrated, but in the transistor and diodes are connected as a discrete component to form a complete circuit. Thin and thick film IC. The essential difference between the thin and thick film IC is not their relative thickness, but the method of deposition of film. Basically, the difference between thick and film not only relative thickness. In the main difference is deposition of film. In thick film, type resistors and interconnection patterns are printed on a ceramic substrate. In thin film, the resistors and interconnection patterns are deposited by vacuum evaporation. technique on a glass or glazed ceramic substrate. Both have similar appearance, properties and general characteristics. Now it comes the classification of ICs on the basis of chip size. One is small scale integration, then medium scale integration, large scale integration, very large scale integration, then ultra large scale integration. Now we will see in this classification number of transistors and other components they contain. Small scale integration up to 100 electronic components per chip. In medium scale from 100 to 3000 electronic components per chip. In large scale integration from 3000 to 1 lakh electronic components per chip. In very large scale integration 1 lakhs to 10 lakhs components per chip. In ultra large scale integration more than 1 billion electronic components per chip. In this classification, we can also see how many gates, design per chip or other electronic components per chip. In small integration, has 3 to 30 gates per chip, up to 100 electronic components per chip. In medium scale integration, has 30 to 300 gates per chip or 100 to 3000 electronic components per chip. Now in LSI and VLSI, large scale integration, it contains 300 to 3000 gates per chip or 3000 to 1 lakh electronic components per chip. In case of very large scale integration, more than 3000 gates per chip or 1 lakh to 10 lakh electronic components per chip. ULSI, ultra large scale integration, more than 1 million electronic components per chip. The Intel 486 and Pentium microprocessor, for example, use ULSI technology. The line between VLSI and ULSI is vague. Integrated circuits can be further classified: analog integrated circuits, digital integrated circuits, and mixed signal integrated circuits. Mixed signal integrated circuit means both analog and digital on the same chip. Analog integrated circuits, analog ICs such as sensors, power management circuits and operational amplifiers work by processing continuous signal. We define here analog integrated circuit means the signal continuously change with respect to time. That is analog integrated. Work on the continuous change in the signal. They perform functions like amplification, active filtering, demodulation and mixing. Analog IC is the burden on circuit designer by having expertly designed analog circuit available instead of designing a difficult analog circuit. Digital integrated circuits can contain anything from 1 to millions of logic gates, flip-flop, multiplexers and other circuits in a few square millimeters. The small size of these circuits allow high speed, low power consumption and reduce manufacturing cost compared with board level integration. These digital ICs typically microprocessors, DSP and microcontrollers work using binary mathematics to process 1 and 0 signals. Basically, we have seen here the digital IC. Actually, these ICs work on discrete nature, or you can say switch on and off or transition high to low. Mixed signal IC can also combine analog and digital circuits on a single chip to create functions such as A to D converters and D to A converters. Such circuits offer small size and lower cost but must carefully account for signal interfacing. One more classification of IC on the basis of applications. One is linear integrated circuits and second is digital integrated circuits. Linear integrated circuits, when the input and output relationship of a circuit is linear, known as linear IC, are used, input and output can take place on continuous range of value. For example, operational amplifiers, power amplifiers, microwave amplifiers and multipliers, etc. Basically, linear integration means satisfying the homogeneity principles and superposition principles. Digital integrated circuit, when the circuit is either in on state or off state and not in between the two stages, the circuit is called the digital circuit. ICs used in such circuits are called digital integrated circuits. These find wide applications in computers, logic circuits, for example, logic gates, flip-flops, counters, microprocessors, memory chips, etc. Structure of IC. Step 1, system specification. Means first you take the specification of your circuit. That technical name is defined here, system specification. After that, architectural design. In this, you can design as per your specification the architectural design of the circuit. Now, third step, functional design and logic design. Means as per your specification, you can design functional design and logic design of the circuit. After that, fourth step, circuit design. Circuit design, for example, multiplexer, demultiplexer, adder circuits, we can design here. Now, physical design of the circuit. Physical design means where we connected ICs or wires. After that, physical verification and sign off. Physical verification means we just check out the circuit, which pin is connected or not connected, wire is connected or not connected. After that, fabrication. Which step we follow for fabricating the IC? Actually, fabrication takes several steps. Here, I just give the structure flow diagram only. Packaging and testing. And after packaging, your chip is ready. Now, IC packaging is the last step and very important step of IC fabrication or IC structures. Single line packaging, dual line packaging, zigzag line packaging. Single line packaging, a single line packaging has one row of connecting pins. It is not as popular as dual line packaging, but it has been used for packaging RAM chip and multiple registers with a common pin. Single line package group RAM chips together on small board either by dual inline package process or surface mounting SMD process. Dual line packaging. A dual line packaging is an electronic component packaging with a rectangular housing and two parallel rows of electrical connecting pins. This packaging may be through hole mounted to a printed circuit board or inserted in a socket. Zigzag line packaging. The zigzag line packaging or ZIP was short lived packaging technology for integrated circuits, particularly dynamic RAM chip. A ZIP is an integrated circuit encapsulated in a slab of plastic with 20 or 40 pins. Measuring for ZIP 20 package about 3 mm into 30 mm into 10 mm with respect to length, width and height. Advantages of IC. Very small size, low cost, reduced power consumption, highly reliable, higher operating speed, reduced external wire connections, easy to use. Disadvantages of ICs: component dependent, limited capacitance, impossible to fabricate transformers, limited power supply, not flexible. I conclude that what are the importance of integrated circuit. Extremely small size, 1000 times smaller than discrete circuit. It is because of fabrication of various circuit elements in a single chip of semiconductor material. Very small weight due to miniaturized circuit. Very low cost because of simultaneously production of hundreds of similar circuits on a small semiconductor wafer. Due to mass production on IC cost much as individual transistors. More reliable because of elimination of solder joints and need for few interconnections. Low power consumption because of their small size. Easy replacement as it more economic to replace them than to repair them. Increase operating speeds because of absence of parasitic capacitance effect. Parasitic capacitance, it is generated due to junction or bias. Now we comes to the improved functional performance as more complex circuits can be fabricated for achieving better characteristics. Means ICs are reduced the complexity of the circuit. Greater availability of operating at extreme temperature. Means more of IC operating at high temperature also. Suitable for small signal operation because no chance to stray electrical pickup as various components of an IC are located very close to each other on a single wafer. No component protect above the chip surface in an IC as well as, or we can say IC, all the components are formed within the chip.